So today I'm going to talk about Wacom tablets and their advantages for photographers undertaking post-production.
Thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video.
I've got two new Wacom tablets here that I'm about to unbox. One of them is the Intuos Pro Medium size, and the other one is the Intuos Pro Small size. Let's take a look at them. So, what's in the boxes and which size is going to be best for you and why? Well, immediately unpacking those, the first thing that I've seen is a device here with each one of these. I'm not actually even sure what that is. Oh yes, I am. It's the pen holder that the pen simply goes into. So let's unpack one of those. Now, normally in these, inside, yep, they have the extra nibs, spare nibs for the pen. So that's weighted at the bottom. That's quite heavy, that piece of metal. And then there's a dial where you can rotate it to unlock the base so you can access those nibs. Put that back together again, and that's the base holder for the pen. Pen's got some protective wrapping around it, and that's your pen holder. So that's a new design compared to the old design here. The other interesting thing that I've just noticed, and this was actually the main reason I bought this Intuos Medium, this is the Intuos Medium Pro here. This is also the Intuos Medium Pro, but look at the size difference. This is the older model, and this is the newer model. And this is really important to me, actually, this size difference. Measure. So my old Intuos Pro Medium was 38 centimeters by 25 centimeters. The new one is 33.5 by 22. So it's considerably smaller. Now, if you want to compare the small size Wacom tablet with the medium one, there you go. Can you see the differences there? That's the difference between the small and the medium. And the small one measures 26.7 centimeters by 17 centimeters, so considerably smaller. So they are both considerably more compact than their predecessors, but with the same actual working area, that is the area that you use to draw, retouch, etc. That particular area is the same size, but it's the surrounding areas that they've reduced in size, and they've reduced the size area for these buttons as well. So they basically shrunk all that in, which is really, really useful. So why is that actually important to me, that this one has the same working area as this one, but is it's considerably smaller? Well, I'll tell you why it's important to me. I have a 16-inch MacBook Pro, and that 16-inch MacBook Pro just fits into my lovely laptop bag along with my Sony headphones, but this particular tablet did not fit into this bag when I had, it will fit in it, but it won't fit in it when I've got my laptop in there. And I do a lot of traveling overseas where I'm giving presentations and lectures, etc. And I need my Wacom tablet with me. With the new Wacom tablet, no problem at all, fits in my bag really easily. That's the medium size one. So some of you may be asking, well, why don't you just go for the small tablet if you're concerned about the size for travel? And that's a very good question. So the reason I ordered the smaller one as well is that one of the team here wants to learn retouching, and she's never used a tablet before. And she and I both felt that the smaller one would be adequate for her requirements based on her workstation setup. The medium size is the one, as you know, that I use already. So why do I choose the medium, other than I'm used to a medium, which is a good enough reason, but why do I choose the medium compared to using the small version? Well, for my retouching, I use a dual screen setup. I have a large 4K ISO monitor on my office desk. It's a 31-inch panoramic version monitor. And I'm also using my 16-inch MacBook Pro as a second screen alongside it. And the way I like to work is to use both monitors at the same time. And as such, my tablet designates a mapped portion on the left side of my tablet to the ISO monitor, and another mapped portion on the right side of the tablet to my 16-inch screen. This means that on my current medium one, I have this area for my ISO, this area for my 16-inch, they join together in the middle, and then this is kind of dead space down below here. But the actual area that I'm using that's mapped to my ISO here is actually about the same size as the area on a small tablet. So if I were to use a small tablet, then especially with a dual screen setup, then I'd be reducing this area, this working area, down to about this tiny working area, and then the second monitor there, and then dead space down here. So that wouldn't work for me. Now, my colleague Ashley, who's going to be using this one, she's only working on a single screen setup, so that's absolutely fine for her requirements. And actually, in any requirement where you're using a single screen, I think this will probably be perfectly okay. Further to that, with the medium one, even if you were using it on a single screen, you can map a smaller area of the tablet if you wish. And then I prefer the versatility that if I wish to map a smaller area of the tablet with a single screen, that I've still got the larger area of the tablet if I'm working with a dual screen. So that's another good reason why I prefer the larger tablet. Then you might ask, well, why don't you go with the largest tablet size? Because this is the medium, we've looked at the small, but there is an actual bigger one as well. And the problem I find with the largest tablet is that the areas that you need to move across the tablet with your hand, the strokes, are too large and too far. Often I'm zoomed in very close on an image, and therefore it can require broader strokes to retouch and retouch from one point to another. Now, this would be amplified even more to an uncomfortable degree on a bigger tablet. I have, however, used the large Wacom Cintiq screen tablets in the past, and whilst I enjoyed using it, ultimately I ended up going back to my preference for a higher quality screen and a separate tablet. Now, I've often heard it said that it is mostly illustrators and artists that prefer using the larger format tablets, which makes sense because based on the sort of strokes that they might apply, that is probably correct. So what use are these type of tablets for you as photographers? What would you use them for? Well, you can use them as a general replacement for a mouse and use them for all of your pointing work and your desktop tasks on your computer. But for most photographers, we want to use them for retouching work and in particular, burning, dodging, coloration and airbrush style painting. Now, these retouching techniques are best applied with pressure-sensitive application, like a real pen. And with the angle of stroke and the ability to undertake the brush application in a much more fluid way. Now, one of the most useful techniques for photographers is properly learning to burn and dodge. But briefly, let me explain, it is the main tool that photographers need to master to create more three-dimensionality in their images via luminosity and contrast changes. And it's not simply advisable trying to master those techniques with a mouse. Now, once you become familiar with using a tablet for this type of work, you'll never want to work any other way. In fact, you'll find that every professional retoucher on the planet uses a tablet for work such as this. So let's take a look at the pricing of these units and some others. Currently at B&H Photo, the Intuos Pro Medium is retailing for about $300, and the Intuos Pro Small is retailing for about $130. Now, Wacom also do some more basic tablets without all the fancy programmable buttons there on the side, and those tablets start for as low as around $60. Other options include using an iPad with a sketch pen and an app, but I've tried these in the past and they always seem to be a bit laggy and they don't have that same intuitive feel of using a proper tablet like these. So that explains some of the reasons for the size differences and what the main purpose of a tablet is to photographers. In one of the following episodes, I'm going to show you how to set one of these up to your computer, how to personalize it, and how to map specific areas of the tablet to your screen. And I'll also explain what all these buttons are for, and you'll get to watch Ashley getting to grips using one of these for the first time. Thanks for watching.
This video is brought to you by Squarespace. From websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business. Head to squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/Karl to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.